You did a stint as Secretary of State, 7 or so years as mayor of Dallas. You resigned to run for the Senate. Then you went back into private life, practiced law, came back out to be the USTR. Do you prefer being in private life or public life better?
Yes.
Which one? You like them? You like them both. No, I'm going to make you pick.
I can tell you that my bride loves the time that I tease her with the prospect of being an income-producing spouse.
So that's what she cares about.
Yeah. No, look, I'm blessed to have been able to do both.
Right.
You know, ironically, as a kid growing up in Austin, you know, and Austin's a wonderful place to be from. But, you know, 60 years ago, we were still the segregated South.
Very different Austin.
And it was a very different Austin, and we weren't as welcome on this council, I mean, on this campus or anywhere else. And so all my dreams were animated by my parents' passion to make sure that my three sisters and brother and I were going to have a very different future for them.
Yeah.
And they believed that everything President Johnson was doing, which I have to note, because we have just celebrated 50th anniversary of everything.
And it
really reminds us just what a wonderfully gifted legislator, president, leader LBJ was. But I was inspired to be the next Thurgood Marshall.
Right.
And from the time I was a kid, I knew who Thurgood Marshall was.
He really did play a disproportionate role for you growing up as a role model.
He absolutely did, and that was a wonderful editorial. And I know we're short on time,
but
finally just writing about the courage of him. Because I think Thurgood gets lost sometime in the very legitimate debate about the role of Dr. King versus Malcolm X and the militants, because people didn't see the energy. But this guy was going into segregated courthouses by himself.
Right.
Suing white people.
And this is long before most of the country knew him.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
I mean, even as a boy, I mean, there was this riddle. I guess I can say it. I'm at home now. When I'm 60, I can say what I want. But, you know, even as a kid, there was this riddle. They'd always ask us, you know, what's the difference between the Ku Klux Klan and the Supreme Court? And the answer was the Supreme Court wore black robes and scared the hell out of white people.
Yeah.
And so that was a long time
ago. That's a long time ago. Right.
But anyway, I was animated. That's why I wanted to be a lawyer.
Right.
And I really, I, you know, having watched my parents struggle against a poll tax and fight for the right to vote,
right,
you know, the idea of not voting, not being civically involved was just not in our DNA. But my dreams were all to be a part of that fight for justice through the courts.